Hi, I'm Peter Wolfgang, and I want to welcome you to the second episode of FIC Action Update. We are filming from here in Hartford, Connecticut, to talk to you about some of the things that are happening at our state capitol and what you, the pro-family citizens of the state of Connecticut, can do to help. And for that, I throw it over to Christina.
Hi, I'm Christina Bennett, Communications Director for FIC, and today I am going to be asking Peter some of the questions that have come to us from concerned citizens that want to support pregnancy centers but need a little bit more information about what's going on. So, Peter, the first question I have is this bill, HB 5130 and Senate Bill 395, an act concerning deceptive advertising practices of limited services pregnancy centers, what does this bill entail, and if this bill became a law, what would it do to pregnancy resource centers here in Connecticut?
So, Christina, what these bills purport to do is outlaw so-called deceptive advertising by the pregnancy centers. The proponents of these bills, the pro-abortion activists and their friends at the state capitol, believe that the pregnancy centers here in Connecticut, of which there are about 25, that they somehow deceive women, that in their advertising, that they somehow lure women in by suggesting that they do abortions when they don't do abortions, and then by deceit and trickery that they somehow prevent these women from having abortions. That happens not to be true. They produce no evidence to back that up. But that's the basis of that bill, and that's what those two bills claim to do.
And I can recall, actually, that when we went to the Public Health Committee last year, because there's a similar bill, and pro-abortion activist groups were using an example of pregnant need help as right. False advertising. I think that would be pretty radical to think that pregnant need help would be considered to be false advertising.
And we should explain, too, why that's so radical. What the pro-abortion folks at the state capitol in 2018, last year, were arguing was that pregnant need help, by definition, is deceptive if the help doesn't include abortion. Now, the whole point of these pro-life centers is to honestly and properly help women who might otherwise be abortion-minded to carry their child to term. These centers are pro-life. They don't do anything illegal. They don't even advocate on the underlying issue of abortion itself, on whether that should be legal or illegal. All they do is offer another choice. Remember, pro-abortion people say they're just pro-choice. That's all these centers do. And so to say that a sign that just says pregnant need help is somehow deceptive because the help doesn't include abortion, I think really crosses the line and exposes how radical their agenda against these centers is.
Yes, absolutely. Especially since these centers are offering help such as parenting classes, material resources, baby showers, diapers and clothes, and a number of other things. And so they really are offering, you know, multiple ways that they can help women. So my second question that we've heard a few times is, the pregnancy centers are doing good work, and if they're doing good work, then isn't that enough? Why are they being attacked? Wouldn't their good work just speak for themselves? Why are people coming after them?
You would think so, wouldn't you?
You'd hope.
Here's what it looks like to us. We think the reason why this is happening is that the rate of abortion is dropping here in the state of Connecticut and even nationally. It's not just us saying it. The Waterbury Republican American, the daily newspaper of Waterbury, Connecticut, had an editorial on Friday, January 25th, flat out saying the same thing, that the real reason this is happening is because the abortion rate is dropping, and that the proponents of abortion, who, for them, this is a business, they make money off of this, they want to take out the competition. The pro-abortion forces, rightly, I think, have concluded that one of the reasons abortion is dropping is because of the success of these pro-life centers. So what they want to do is use the heavy hand of the state to take out their competition. This was said explicitly by state legislators during the previous public hearing that, look, it looks to us like you're just targeting these centers, that this isn't some neutral across the board thing that you're doing, that you're deliberately targeting these centers because you don't like the competition.
Now, we know that this is happening, like I mentioned, across the state in these national campaigns. And so in California, what was happening there is the government in California forced pro-life pregnancy centers to give out information about abortion. And that went all the way up to the Supreme Court in the Supreme Court case, Nifla versus Becerra. Thankfully, thankfully, the Supreme Court sided in favor of the pregnancy centers and said it was unjust, unconstitutional, against their free speech rights to force these pro-life centers to give out abortion information. But does that case help the pregnancy centers here in Connecticut, that win? Does it make a difference here?
Well, that case, that win at the U.S. Supreme Court, Christina, is hugely important because what the U.S. Supreme Court said is that there is no exception to the First Amendment right to free speech for pro-lifers. That's essentially what the pro-abortion side was arguing, that our First Amendment right to free speech somehow doesn't apply to people who are doing pro-life work. So that the U.S. Supreme Court ruled for the pro-life side in NIFLA is huge. I don't want to understate it in any way. But the reason why we're still facing this in Connecticut is this. 2 days after the NIFLA ruling came down, the U.S. Supreme Court denied cert. That is, they refused to hear a case out of San Francisco about a municipal ordinance that regulated the pro-life pregnancy centers in San Francisco. It was not as extreme as the state one in California that was shot down. But what the people here in Connecticut, the pro-abortion side, is now arguing is that because the Supreme Court refused to hear that case, then that San Francisco ordinance must be good law. That's not necessarily the case. We don't think that's the case at all, but that's what they're hanging their hat on. So that very likely is going to be a key part of the argument between the two sides at the state capitol in Hartford. Is this good law? I don't think it is. I think the state of Connecticut runs a big risk of lawsuits if they go ahead and pass this. We hope it doesn't get to that point. What we want to do is stop this bill from ever becoming a law in the state of Connecticut, and that's what we're going to work to do.
Absolutely. And what's the process? What can we expect in the coming days, the coming weeks concerning these bills, and what can people do?
Well, first and foremost, these bills have already been proposed. So what you need to do, you need to be on the Family Institute of Connecticut Action's email list. If you go to ctfamily.org, you can sign up for our email list. Click on Take Action. You can sign up for our email list. And what we're going to be doing, if we have your street address, you will be getting an e-blast from us where we make it very simple. You can click the link at the bottom in order to send an email to your own state senator and state representative that we have helped to prepare, asking them not to support these bills. And do not give up hope. Even if your state legislator doesn't share our pro-life views, is pro-abortion, even if they were endorsed by a pro-abortion group, that doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to support these bills. They care what their constituents think. That's why it is so important for everyone watching this video to contact their state senator and state representative and ask them to vote no on this. Because if enough people do, this bill might get pulled and not get a vote at all in committee as it did last year. Now, I don't want to overstate that. The fact is the pro-abortion people picked up a lot more friends in the last election. It's going to be harder to do this year, but it's still doable. So that's the first thing, is be on our email list so that you can contact your state legislators. The second thing is, at some point, FIC Action is going to have a lobby day at the state capitol. We're going to need you at the state capitol to come up. We'll have talking points. We'll be able to train you and help you with this, but we'd like you to speak directly to your state senator and state representative. We need people to write notes. We need people to make phone calls. We need people to speak directly to their own state legislator. The third thing is, sometime, this could be very soon, it could be any, you know, in the next week or two, or it could be as late as, you know, the third week of March, maybe around St. Patrick's Day. But at some point, there is going to be a public hearing at the state capitol on these bills. I think it's very unlikely that they won't get a public hearing because the other side, the pro-abortion folks, have so much strength at the Capitol. We are going to need you to come to the state Capitol on that day to testify against that bill. Again, as with our lobby day, we'll work with you, we'll help prepare you for this, but it's very important if you can get the day off from work, if you can get babysitting, if you're a homeschooler, if you have a Christian school, bring the kids up. We need as big numbers as possible. We'll have stickers you can wear. We'll have a room reserved where we can explain everything to you up there. But again, we're going to need as many people as possible to come to the state capitol for the public hearing. And then after that, there will be more lobbying, more emails to be sent after the public hearing, because our first goal is to kill this bill in committee, is to make sure, as we did last year, that it doesn't even make it out of committee. If, unfortunately, it gets voted out of committee, then we're on to the House or Senate, where we're going to have to lobby a larger number of legislators. But right now, we need everyone to contact their own state legislator and then to come help us lobby whatever committee hears this bill. Those are the most immediate things.
Wonderful. Well, that's all the information that we have for you guys today. But if you have questions, feel free, go on our website. There's our contact information. You can call our office. You can shoot us an email. And we'd be more than willing to talk with you about any other questions that you have regarding these bills.
Thank you.
Thank you.